closing my WCS notes because we are done with that.
That is a big file. It was a very big file. So we postponed this from last after session because Val's 20-minute rant turned into 40 minutes. I have so much more to say, too, but we're not going to get to that. We were going to talk about summer conventions destroying our health in the heat because there's been so many. And I should probably put the little disclaimer of, yes, I understand why cons hold their events in the summers, particularly anime cons, because a lot of the youngins are out of school and it's easier to catch them and have them come in and spend money and not have to worry about school schedules. Like, I get it. Makes sense. Fine. And it's easier for some people, too, to take vacation time during the summer. So, I get it. It still sucks because it's really hot outside. And ACs tend to break everywhere.
I mean, you know in advance, especially if it's in Texas.
Yeah.
Or places that regularly get very hot.
Mm-hmm.
That it's going to be unhealthily hot outside. In other words, people should not spend long periods of time outside. They're eventually going to have to go indoors.
Yeah.
And I'm not going to name names, but there is at least one convention where you have the hotel and then you have a convention center that sits next to the hotel. And you have to go through some double doors to pass between either side. So some events are in the hotel, some events are in the convention center. And if you want to attend different events on other sides, you have to open the doors, go out, open the doors, go in. And because the convention takes place for something like 18 hours a day, if not 24/7 in some spots, those doors are constantly opening and shutting. Which means you're letting all of the hot air in and all of the cold air out. And it's like, you know, that's something that you need to take into consideration when you're having the con during the hottest part of the summer.
Mm-hmm.
Just like the general July, August months. That entire period is the hottest part of summer here. And it's like, it's not, if you set the thermostat at, say, 68, 70, it's not going to be that temperature inside because you're constantly having the doors open. So it's still going to be even warmer inside than you intended it to be. Plus, then you have all the body heat of the people that are in those centers.
Mm-hmm.
Especially because multiple cons will set up large areas on the first floor of convention centers and hotels. Things like Dealer's Den, like Artist Alley, like special events, ceremonies, bands, things like that. Things where there are going to be a lot of people all the time while it's open.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to have a lot of bodies in there.
Yeah.
Generating heat.
Generating more heat.
So even if you have a working AC that is tuned and works as intended, it's still going to probably be 5 or 10 degrees hotter than that in the center or the hotel.
Mm-hmm.
Between those things. And so it already feels hot being in there. And then you have what happens when that AC fails. Because it just can't keep up.
Because it can't keep up.
And at some point, you reach that level where people just don't want to be at the con.
Yeah.
Because they're uncomfortable.
It's too
hot. They don't feel good. Right. And you start seeing signs of heat exhaustion where people start to get nauseous and faint and they just don't want to be there.
Mm-hmm.
And that's not great for your con. People aren't going to spend money. People aren't going to go to panels unless they're indoors where they can get air conditioning. They're not going to go to concerts. They're not going to go to the Dealer's Den or Artist Alley. They're going to go up to their hotel rooms or they're going to leave to go somewhere that's air conditioned.
Mm-hmm.
That's not good for the con, for attendance or for profits. And so, I mean, not that my advice means anything, but my advice would be perhaps consider holding your con sometime other than July and August.
It's just too dang hot.
I mean, yes, there's always the chance that you are competing with another con that takes place that weekend.
Sure.
And sometimes it's even other large cons. Like if you chose to hold it over, say, Labor Day weekend. Yes, there is another
big ass cons happening on Labor Day.
There, there's another set of cons that take place. Yes, you will be fighting for attendees, but also bear in mind that not everyone that wants to go to those other big cons can, and they're going to want an alternative.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's a local alternative, or at least takes a lot less travel, that'll be a lot more attractive to those folks.
Right.
Who still have money to spend that they would have spent at these other big cons had they been able to go.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't even have to necessarily hold it Labor Day weekend. You could have it a weekend later. And I realized that not every convention will be able to get the schedule they want because it's dependent on the convention center that you rent out.
Sure.
I get it. I totally get it. But sometimes it's better to take the less bad of the two options. So if you have a less favorable time, like, say, end of September, I mean, yeah, it's not great. Everybody's in school and there's no vacation time around there. But it may still be a better overall time for you than, say, like August 27th.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just picking these dates out of thin air. I don't even know what days of the week they are. Just sometimes you have to make a really hard choice. And I would say that generally speaking, the middle of summer is not the healthier of the two.
not unless conventions both on the administrative side and the convention centers themselves are much more forgiving and open in how they plan things. And simple things like let people bring in water. Don't make them stand outside in line for 6 to 10 hours and have a no water rule. That is ridiculous. You're going to kill people. Just let them have their bottle of water. Get over it. I know some people are going to try and sneak in some alcoholic drinks. They're still sneaking them in anyway. Let them have their water bottle. It's fine. Or just like thinking of the spacing and the sizing of the convention center. If you have people spread out throughout more of the facility, you do better on the heat distribution, and it ensures that the AC can work more properly and more efficiently versus cramming everybody into one small section. There are definitely different ways of doing it to make it work if you have to have it in the summer, but it's a logistics thing, and they just got to think it through.
It helps with the crowding issue too, especially because I know that there are a lot of attendees that have claustrophobia issues. And whenever you have these really packed hallways as people are traversing back and forth to get to events,
mm-hmm.
sometimes there's no room to move around at all.
Right.
Especially when there's big events going.
Right.
And you have things like cosplay contest or the concerts or masquerade, mm-hmm. things like that, where there are just large volumes of people. Having the extra space can be very helpful. But I was also going to mention that if you don't allow people to bring in their own water bottles, at least please sell it at reasonable prices or have vendors that do. Please don't have people wait in line for 8 to 10 hours and then charge them $6 to $8 for a bottle of water. Please don't. It's just compounding the issue and it makes you look really bad.
I'm honestly at the point where because water is a necessity for human life, mm-hmm. The majority of our body is made of water. It should just be free. You can be mad at me all you want to, but it's water. We need it to live. We need it to survive. We need it to not pass out on the side of the walk while we're waiting in line. It should just be free and accessible to everybody. Let's stop commodifying it.
It doesn't have to be anything more fancy than that. We're not asking for juice. We're not asking for Gatorade or Powerade. It doesn't have to be anything fancy. Literally just plain water.
Just plain old water. That's it.
Mm-hmm. Yes. I would say preferably not tap water. At least filter it, please.
If possible.
Yes. And that's because tap water is different in different areas. But that's it. Nothing fancy.
Yeah. I know it's, at least for us in southern states, we're kind of more aware of having water stations throughout certain areas of the convention because we get it. It gets really hot here really quickly, so you need access to water. And they tend to make it readily available. It tends to be more of the northern, the eastern, and the western conventions that don't really participate in this practice, and it's rather unfortunate. It's like, oh, it's just water, guys. We all need it. Let us have our stinking water.
Also, something to think about are food offerings when it's that hot outside.
Mm-hmm.
If you offer junk food, it can actually make people feel worse in the heat and they'll start to feel sick.
Yeah.
So if you offer typical things that you might find in, say, a sports stadium or a movie theater as your meals of choice for your attendees, I get that it's cheap. I get that it's readily available. That's not what your attendees need to be eating.
Mm-hmm.
Not when it's 100 degrees outside. Please offer healthier options that are better for the heat.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't all have to be cold. I'm not saying, you know, everything has to be boba tea
or
and ice cream.
Like,
yeah, you don't have to offer salads like the whole time. You can still offer food, but please make it healthful food so that they don't feel sick after eating it. And preferably something that people can eat slowly. Because when you're overheated like that, if you try and scarf something down, no matter what the food is, it's not going to go well.
No.
So you'll want something that, you know, people can just graze on and mm-hmm. still be healthy.
Mm-hmm.
Street food trucks are great for that. Much better than, you know, stadium nachos or popcorn, neither of which are really great for the heat.
No.
So just saying. Setting aside all the dietary issues with food generally offered at cons.
Yeah, and it's interesting because it seems like more and more people have dietary restrictions that you think they'd be more accommodating, but still just everywhere it's popcorn, and God, I'm so tired of the popcorn smell. Not everybody can eat popcorn.
We know that there are going to be so many different dietary restrictions that you can't cover them all.
You can't cover all of them. It's impossible.
We get that. And most of the time, people with dietary restrictions will bring their own food.
Yeah, we'll find ways. Even if we're not allowed to bring it in, we will still find ways to bring it in because we got to eat or we get sick. Mm. Imagine
right.
that.
And sometimes you just have to eat specific food.
Yeah.
That the con just does not
have.
Right. And so generally, we'll take care of ourselves, but it would help if we could be met halfway.
Yeah. Even if there's just another option, knowing that I could potentially get a salad. It's like, oh, hey, I can actually consume something here. Who'da thunk?
Or if I need to cool off, you know, maybe there is a decaf boba tree truck.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
I'm willing to pay for the food. Generally, street food trucks have reasonable prices.
Yeah, tend to have a good variety of options. So there's something that you can kind of mix and match and make it work for you.
Mm-hmm.
It'd just be nice to have the option. That's all.
Right. And I know in some places there may be street restrictions that they can't.
Oh, yeah.
But, I mean, arrangements can generally be made with other vendors to, like, sell food inside if
mm-hmm.
that's what you have to do.
Mm-hmm. There are ways away to make it work.
Yep. And the other thing is that we as cosplayers also need to be cognizant of is if somebody is very clearly taking a break from the heat, please let them.
Mm-hmm.
Please don't bother them for pictures. Please don't try and, you know, strike up a conversation about your fandom. Let them take a break and they'll approach you when they're ready.
Mm-hmm.
Or they'll signal when they're ready.
Mm-hmm.
But if somebody looks like they're not feeling well, like, help them take a break. It's okay to take a break in cosplay. And we should support that. Same thing with eating. Same thing. If you need to take a phone call, please do.
Mm-hmm.
If you need to go get a drink of water, definitely please do. If you don't have a cosplay helper, please make a friend. As long as it is a trusted friend. And just watch each other's back.
Mm-hmm. Good habits to have.
Mm-hmm. And if you don't feel good, please go talk to medical staff. They are there to help you. It's much better to get the help early.
Yes.
Than have it be much harder later.
Yes.
Because the later part is not fun. Later, I've seen enough of it at enough con that it is not fun.
It's not fun. It makes things worse. The sooner that you recognize, oh, I need some help, ask for the help. You will be mm-hmm. provided with the help that you need.
Yeah. And if you start feeling like you're going down that road of maybe needing help, like if you're starting to feel a little dizzy, if you're mm-hmm. starting to feel just a little off, it's okay to slow down.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, you don't have to necessarily sit down right there in the middle of the floor, but just take it slow, take it easy, relax, give yourself extra time, give yourself extra water, and just slow down.
Just take a moment to breathe, relax, do some meditations, step off to the side, find a seat, get comfy, chill out. The things are still going on. Things are still going to be there. Your friends are still going to be fine. Like, everybody can chill. That's the whole point of the con is to have fun and enjoy yourself. And if you're not feeling well, you're not enjoying yourself. So just relax. Have a moment. Have some peanut butter crackers.
And some cons have sensory rooms now.
Yeah, that's nice.
That are specifically for relaxing and just shutting out the con for a while. Shutting out the noise, the crowds. Exactly. It's meant to be a very anti-anxiety experience. Mm-hmm. And so if you feel like you need to take a moment, if they have one of those rooms, please go find it. They're really helpful. I say this as a person who suffers from immense anxiety.
They come in handy.
Yeah. I'm generally not a fan of going to cons during the hot times of the year. I don't care how good the con is.
It's just...
it's not worth it.
It's so much. And I know I could do it when I was younger. It's difficult for me to ascertain doing it now. Like, I can't imagine myself doing Dragon Con ever again. It's just, it's not really the heat there. It's the humidity. It is just so stank and humid. You just feel like you are constantly sweating. Because with Dragon Con, it literally is like the entire downtown area of Atlanta. And it's just you walking between four hotels. When you're in the hotels themselves, they do a good enough job of keeping the AC. Like, the ACs are built to actually maintain the high crowds. It's not a big deal. It's just because of all of that walking between the pathways and outside, it's just so much. And I just can't imagine going again without being physically drained within 10 seconds of being there. I don't think I could do it again.
I think I was more willing to tolerate it when I was younger because I was more willing to accept the suffering in return for what I thought was going to be like a really fun time at the con.
Right.
Like the reward was going to be worth the risk, in other words. And so I would go for photo shoots outside in full costume,
They were not,
summer appropriate costumes. Many of them had full armor.
Yep.
And I would pour sweat and I would suffer. And I would get lightheaded and I would not feel good by the time I got back to the hotel, where even at that point, you feel so sick that even the air conditioning doesn't really help.
Mm-hmm.
You basically have to go to a hotel room, take everything off and just sit and let your body cool off.
Yep.
And it's not a good feeling. And now that I've gotten a little bit older and more experienced in the convention and cosplay worlds, that I've found that it's just not worth the payoff.
It's not worth it.
I can do a photo shoot any other time.
Yep.
I can make other plans and go to other conventions if I want to. And the sick, nauseous feeling that you get after it is just not worth what
gross.
You have to go through. Like the photo shoot or the meeting of friends or whatever is just not worth it. I would rather just delay it. Do everything indoors and just delay it. Or don't even go to that con. Just go to a different con and see your friends another time.
Yeah. At a cooler it's not time worth of year it. With a different costume, you know.
Yeah. I already don't have a lot of free time. And so what little free time I do have is very precious to me. And I like to spend it in ways that are of best benefit to me and my friends. So I think I've just grown a lot more aware of that as I've gotten older.
Yeah. It's definitely a thing where, as we've done as many cons as we have for as many years as we've been to conventions, it's just things that you learn over time. And it's like the last time that we did a contest together, I was like, I ain't doing this ever again. This was a nightmare. If I can't do it in 2 hours or less, I ain't doing it.
I mean, we've both stopped going to so many cons. We've both stopped doing Con Crunch. We've stopped doing elaborate costumes for the most part because all of these things just take more out of you than it gives you in return. And it's better just to have fun. even if you're not wearing a costume at all. It's just so much easier. It's like a load off. It's great.
I'm giggling at two things you said.
Did I say something funny?
I did, because I thought it was funny. Because one, Val has never done Con Crunch. She's never subscribed to that theory.
My version of Con Crunch is not the general version of Con Crunch. For me, Con Crunch is working on a costume 3 days before con.
That I've never That's done that. I always left a made sure to leave a week beforehand. If I can't get a week of rest beforehand, it's not going to get done, and I'll just wear it another time. That was my that was my rule.
Yeah, but I've never worked on anything like at the hotel.
No, I know plenty of people who have, and plenty of people that do. Mom is saying, please don't do that. It's bad for your health. But then you saying that don't really make as many elaborate costumes, and I'm just thinking, I just made Snow White very recently, and that's a hefty costume.
I did say not as many.
Not as many.
I didn't say none. I mean, heaven knows the one I'm working on, I'm literally adding bling to.
Just throw crystals and diamonds and glitter at it. It's
fine. I am adding gems to it.
But yeah.
And it may or may not have embroidery later. I'm not sure. Anyways.
And definitely the next one will have quite a bit of embellishment on it when I figure out how to make it work. Book first. That's got to get done.
But in other words, we're making healthier choices.
Yes, that is more accurate. Yes, we are definitely making much healthier choices that are beneficial for us physically and mentally. That's the key
part. We would recommend the same to others. I know it may not necessarily seem like it now, but honestly, it's the truth when you get to a certain level of experience.
It is 1,000 times more fun being dorks with your friends in casual clothing and having just a dumb little wig on and walking around the con and just chit-chatting about everything and nothing than it is wearing 50 layers of chiffon and boiling hot sweat pouring down your face to stand in a corner for an hour before you have to take the whole thing off and be miserable the rest of the day because you've overheated.
Right, or to have to go outside
to
do a photo shoot with said costume on. And
it's all white, so you can't sit anywhere. You can't have anything touch it.
Nor can you eat anything.
No, I would still eat. I don't care. I need my food and water. If it stains, it stains.
It's just not worth the experience.
It's not.
That's it.
You can still have your fun, elaborate costumes, and you can have times and places to utilize them. It's just being conscious about your choices, making sure that you pick something that works for you, works for your body, works for your endurance and your stamina, and what makes you happy.
Mm-hmm. You do you.
Yes.
For whatever that means.
Whatever that means. You do you.
Yep. And if you want to go to conventions in July and August, go right ahead. Have fun.
It's still too hot.
I know.
So for me, no.
Yeah, I will not be doing any summer cons anytime soon.
I'm not going to be planning on any summer cons. If I ever happen to go to one, I will be in the most casual of casual wear, no costuming, and it will just be there for press duties to take a couple photos, call it. I'm good.
All right. Well, of course, if you would like to let us know your experience at summer convention cons, or if you'd like to let us know maybe some tips for better being able to survive in the heat, please feel free to join in the conversation via any of our social media, which, of course, you can find here.
Since this is a video only after session that is exclusive on YouTube, all the information is located underneath Amber right over there. Can't miss it. Plus, we're also now on Blue Sky. Find us as CosPod. Enjoy.
You can also email us. podcast@cospod.org, where you will get an answer from each one of us along with curated Nick Cage memes,
which is also recently updated. Yay!
Indeed. Otherwise, please stay safe, stay healthy out there, keep working on those cosplays so that we can all see your smiling, shining faces at a convention local to us ASAP.
Yay!
Otherwise, we will see you all in episode 283. Happy cosplaying, everybody.
Bye.
Good night.